a journey to Bethlehem.
Judea! Tell you, call my servants to the inner court so you may refresh yourselves and see if I can help this matter person. Some of the priests at once. A star in the sky! A baby who would be born to be king? Madness! Utter madness! I am a king!
The priest, as you requested.
Gentlemen, you may have heard there is an uproar in the city here today. A group of magi from the east have come here claiming to see a star in the sky. According to this, this means a baby will be born, who will be king of the Jews. Tell me, is there any record of such prophecy in the ancient Jewish prophets?
Why, yes, Your Majesty. In the book Isaiah, the prophet writes, "For unto us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. And he shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of his government and peace there will be no end."
Your Majesty, there is another writing in the prophet Micah. It states, "But you, Bethlehem, the land of Judah, are by no means least out of the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Your Majesty, it is prophesied that this baby will be born in Bethlehem.
Bethlehem, eh? Out of Bethlehem will come a ruler? We will see about that. Summon the Magi at once! Gentlemen, I am indeed happy for your visit here today. These fine priests have told me about this ancient Jewish prophet Micah, who reported of the baby being born in Bethlehem. Tell me, when exactly did you see this extraordinary star in the sky?
Almost 2 years ago, Your Majesty, and you've been traveling ever since to find it.
We believe that city of Bethlehem is just south of here. Wish you good luck and good fortune on your journey. Go and search carefully for the child. But if you found him, send for me, for I would love to come and worship him as well.
As you wish, Your Majesty.
Thank you.
myself nothing, I do as I please. The city revolves around me. So I've heard there's a rumor that's been stirring, the fulfillment of some prophecy. Oh no, stargazing wise wannabes can outsmart me, Herod the king. Oh, I always get what I want. I always get what I want. I deny myself nothing. Do as I please. Judea revolves around me. It's not easy to win this. This is the thanks that I get. Oh, need a savior when they have me. Everything revolves around me.
Certainly not. We are priests. If the king of the Jews had been born, surely we would have known about it. It would have been a royal affair for all the ages. You really think we could have missed it?
Malachi, can't you see? The stories, the rumors we've heard, they must have been true.
Which stories?
Remember the shepherds who came running through town, ranting about having seen the Christ child and his parents? They were so insistent that their story was true, they went around telling anyone who would listen.
As you mentioned it, I do recall that now. At first, the stories were so ridiculous that I dismissed them without a second thought. But I do remember that there were people saying that they had heard a child being born
in Bethlehem.
Yes, the child was born in Bethlehem.
A child born in Bethlehem? Surely there are other children who have been born there. So who was this child? And why was his birth so important? What about his parents? Who were they, and why were they chosen to be part of his story? Let us find out.
Now the birth of Jesus Christ took place in this way. While his mother Mary was still engaged to Joseph, before they came together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a just man and unwillingly put her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. But as he considered these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream.
Joseph, Joseph, son of David, do not fear taking Mary as your wife, for she has conceived have a son, and you are to call him the name of Jesus. He will save his people from their sins.
took place to fulfill what the Lord had spoken by the prophet Isaiah. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and she shall call his name Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him and took Mary as his wife.
You were the light at the beginning, the one with God, the Lord Most High. Your hand in glory in creation, now revealed in you, Christ.
What a beautiful name it is, what a beautiful name it is. Yeah.
Caesar Augustus, Joseph went out from Nazareth to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David. He traveled there to be registered along with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child.
The journey was long and tedious, especially for Mary, who was so far along in her pregnancy. When they arrived in Bethlehem, the city was bustling with its normal residents, along with others who, like Joseph and Mary, came to Bethlehem to be registered. With the added crowds, lodging was difficult to find, but they were able to find shelter in a stable.
So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Tears are falling, hearts are breaking, how he needs you from God. You've been promised, we've been waiting, welcome, holy child. Welcome, holy child. Hope that you don't mind a man. How I wish we would have known. The long awaited, a holy stranger, make yourself at home. Please make yourself at home. Bring your peace into our violence. Bid our hungry souls be filled. We're now breaking heaven's silence. Welcome to our world. Welcome to our world.
Fragile fingers sent to heal us. Tender wrap prepared for thorn. Tiny heart whose blood unto us is born, unto us is born.
So wrap our injured flesh around you, breathe our air and walk our sob. Rob our sin and make us holy, perfect Son of God. Son of God,
welcome to
same country, shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Suddenly, an angel of the Lord appeared among them.
Thank you.
suddenly the angel was joined by a host of others, the armies of heaven, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
After seeing him, the shepherds told everyone what had happened and what the angel had said to them about this child. All who heard their story were astonished, but Mary kept these things in her heart and thought about them often. The shepherds went back to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen. It was just as the angel had told them.
Child is true, that he is Christ the Lord, the God already has a plan to deal with him.
Hello.
When the wise men heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star, which they had seen in the east, went before them till it came and stood over where the young child was.
When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him.
And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way.
Thank you.